side of the lane. Picks it up, throws it off the left side for Ziegler. Drives into the lane, pull up jumper, short, air ball. Rebounded by the Tigers. Broom the outlet, Holloway, down four, Auburn ball. Holloway 25 to shoot for Auburn, the screen from Broom. Aiden steps back, he's picked up by Adu. Boy, there's the mismatch you want. They get it inside for Broom. Broom drives, kicks it to the corner. Three ball, Denver got it.
There we go, great find by Janai Broom. Kind of got double teamed inside, kicked it out to Denver. Good shot.
That's the lead to one. 2:26, first half of play, 34-33 Vols. Denver Jones, five straight points for the Tigers. Ziegler, left wing James, a three. Nope. Weak side rebound, tapped, and it comes to Chaney Johnson, and a foul is called on the weak side against Denver Jones.
I thought he had inside position on that, Andy.
And Auburn has the ball there going the other way when that foul is called. And Tennessee back at the free throw line, where Tennessee is already 12 of 12 tonight. Denver Jones really reacted. You don't see Denver react that much on that call.
No, I think Denver had inside position. Yeah. I think the official was a little bit out of pocket as far as his angle to what he could see.
Owaka's first over one and bonus is missed. Rebound comes to Janai. Down one, Auburn ball, 2:10 in the first half. Tigers right now have hit their last four field goals. Broom at the top. Hands the ball to Denver Jones and a foul is called on Jordan Ganey for Tennessee. And that finally puts Auburn at the line for a one and bonus. And it will be Denver Jones stepping to the stripe. And an opportunity for Auburn to take the lead here.
It's really good strategy. Denver had made two baskets back to back. End up coming in and running a play for him. End up getting fouled, get to the free throw line.
Free throw by Denver. Ties the game with 2:05 to go in the first half. Six straight points by Denver Jones. And we're tied at 34.
Be nice to see him hit this free throw to get ahead one time during the first half.
Second free throw, and Auburn takes the lead.
Let's force Tennessee to play from behind a little bit now.
7-0 run by Auburn in the last minute, 15, and the Tigers have the lead at the 2-minute mark of the first half of play. Ziegler between the rings, off the right side. Top of the circle, Adu. Around the perimeter, it's James. James underneath for Ganey. Ganey spins into the lane. Wild shot. Missed it. That was a flop, and they called it. Boy, that's just a flop of a call. Chaney Johnson's called for the foul. As physical as this game is, as physical, you don't need the flops to call.
That's for sure.
Ganey at the line for two. First is good.
He's an outstanding free throw shooter as well.
Minute 47 to go in the first half. Second free throw. He got it. Tennessee by a point. Auburn down one with the ball. A minute 43 in the first half. Holloway across midcourt. Broom, right wing, Chad Baker Mazar, and a foul is called as Chad Baker tried to drive to the basket. He was fouled by Jemai Meshack.
I think he got fouled twice on that play there.
He got fouled good, let's put it that way. They called that on Awaka.
They did. Awaka, I think, breathed on him a little bit. Josiah James put his hands on him.
Let me say that. It was Meshack that was called for the foul. Thought he was saying number 11. He was saying 1-1. As KD comes in for Aiden. Remember, Aiden has two fouls. So does KD.
Yeah, that's really smart.
I'm sorry, KD has one.
He's really smart to pull Aiden right now. He's got a minute 37.
Chad Baker Mazar at the line. Auburn down a point, a minute 37 in the first. Chad Baker makes the free throw.
And that's going to be interesting too, Andy. You're going to see Denver playing the point.
It's a good point, Randall.
This group.
1:37 in the first. He can give Auburn the lead here. Second free throw. Good. Chad Baker with seven. Auburn by a point, 37-36. Auburn presses, Ganey off the inbound. He'll bring it up the floor. Ganey across midcourt, moving screen off the right side by James. They get it to the wing for Mayshak. Around the perimeter to James at the top. Now Ziegler outside the arc. 13 to shoot. Drive by Gaines into the lane. Hands the ball down the lane. Bank in is good by Mayshak.
One thing Tennessee does, they really run their offense with high rate of speed. They're always moving. They're a little uncharacteristic of what the Tigers have played this far.
Denver Jones, right wing three. No. Long rebound. Ziegler runs it down for Tennessee. The Vols lead by 157 seconds in the first half. Ziegler to the corner. Three ball, Ganey. Yep. Really, Auburn left their man in the corner.
They sure did. Ziegler drove to the middle of the lane, kind of sucked the defense in, and he made a good pass out to Ganey, and he buried that shot. That was a bad miscue on the Tigers defensively.
33rd three of the year for Ganey, who's come off the bench with 7 points for Tennessee. 49 and a half seconds to go in the first half. Auburn calls a timeout, trailing by four, 41-37.
It's smart timeout here. We might have a chance to go to two for one, is maybe what the coaches are thinking. Try to go down and get a quick basket. Still have time on the clock to, because if when Tennessee gets it back and they're up 4 points, they're going to hold it to the last shot. Or
sure.
They're going to go to the end of the shot clock.
49 and a half seconds to go in half number one in Knoxville. Tennessee 41, Auburn 37. Tigers have led by as many as two. Vols have led by as many as six. We have had 8 lead changes with 6 ties in a closely played first half of basketball.
It's really a good game. It's an outstanding high-level game.
Inbound Denver Jones. Denver up the middle of the floor against Zakai Ziegler. Cross midcourt to the right hand, goes to the wing, Chad Baker-Mazzara. Chad Baker penetrates. Off the left side, Jalen. KD, three ball, yes!
That's good. That's good. There's a little bit difference. Not much. They're going to go to the end of the shot clock on this.
Cuts the lead to one, 41-40 Balls. 25 seconds in the first half and a timeout by Tennessee. The shot clock is off. Excuse me. Yeah, shot clock is off. Tennessee with 24.3 seconds in the first half of play. Work for a final shot. Now let's see. Let's look at some of the first half stats. Auburn has picked up its shooting. 13 of 30 now from the field. 5 of 12 from 3. Tennessee 12 of 27 from the field, 3 of 7 from 3. Auburn 9 of 10 from the free throw line. Tennessee 14 of 15. Rebounding, Tennessee 18, Auburn 15.
Pretty balanced. They've got us a little bit edge on the free throw shooting and a little bit on the rebounding. Big possession right here, Andy. They're going to put Connect back in. They're going to dictate where that shot comes from. They're going to run the shot clock. Clock down, there's 24 seconds left. They're going to try to get Connect off a screen or throw the ball inside to Adu.
Tennessee will have it on its side of the floor, right in front of us down the left sideline. Josiah Jordan James out of Charleston, South Carolina will trigger. Into the backcourt, across midcourt for Zakai Ziegler. 21 seconds in the first half. Tennessee ball, Ziegler. In the center circle, working on Denver Jones. Not doing much, but just dribbling at this point. It's down to 10 seconds in the first half. Ziegler, right-hand dribble. Three balls to Kai Ziegler. Got it. His first field goal of the half. And the first half comes to a close.
He's an outstanding player. Yep. He was a timely scorer. He's been an assist guy. Leads the SEC in assist. But he rose up and made that shot.
Ziegler with a three in the first half. By the way, he already has 5 assists in the first half of play.
He's almost got his average for that.
The score at the half, Tennessee 44, Auburn 40. Time now for the Konecka Sausage Halftime Report. And here's Brad Law.
All right, Andy, thank you very much. One of the big differences in the game, Tennessee is plus 6 in points off turnovers, and the Volunteers are also plus 5 on points at the free throw line. They have made 5 more and attempted 5 more through the first 20 minutes. So both teams shooting a similar percentage from 2, from 3. Percentage-wise, they are fairly close at the free throw line as well. Just small. I mean, it's what happens when you get a four-point game at the break, and that's what it is. 44-40. Remember last year's game in Knoxville where the team scored in the 40s for the entire game? A little different kind of contest tonight. For sure. 44-40 our score at the half. It's time to check the Yellowwood scoreboard here as we get started with our halftime coverage. And there is one other game involving SEC teams tonight, and that is number 24, Florida leading Missouri. Gators have been in control, but they haven't been a way to just completely pull away. 51-44, Gators have the lead with 13 minutes to go in Gainesville. Walter Clayton with 13 points to lead all scorers in that matchup. Outside the SEC, a couple of top 10 teams at home tonight and with double-digit leads. Number 5, Marquette at the half all over Providence, 50-26. And number 10, Duke leads Louisville at the break, 36-23 at Cameron Indoor Stadium. Still to come tonight in the SEC, pair ranked teams are on the road. Interesting games to watch as both of these teams are vying for the SEC regular season championship. Coming up at 7:30 tonight, it'll be 18th-ranked South Carolina playing at Texas A&M. And then 30 minutes after that, a little more than an hour from now, it's number 14 Alabama taking on Ole Miss in Oxford. Also tonight in the top 25, it will be number 8, Iowa State hosting Oklahoma. That game's just about set to tip off in Ames. 12th-ranked Creighton plays host to Seton Hall in an hour in Big East action. Both of those teams in the race for the Big East championship. And then number 6, Arizona plays at Arizona State a couple of hours from now in Pac-12 action. Hey, before we continue, let's pause 10 seconds for station identification on the Auburn Sports Network. To Donnybrook, it's 44-40, a four-point game back and forth in the first half. We'll take a look around Auburn Athletics when we return to the Conecuh Sausage Halftime Report. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly.
And we're back with the action. Coke Zero Sugar might be the best Coke ever?
That's right, Jim. With an irresistible taste and zero sugar, Coke Zero Sugar is a must-try for any sports fan. So make sure you... Wait, Jim, I didn't mean try it right now. We're still on the air.
Best Coke ever? Take a taste, Jen.
Really?
No, not right now, Jen. We got a game to call.
Here's a clip from a recent Talking Tigers podcast with Andy Burcham.
John Mengel.
Describe that night. Because you didn't realize, really, you'd scored 60?
No. If it went a runaway game, I probably wouldn't have had 60. I mean, once we got up 20 plus points, you know, nobody was really guarding anybody, you know, as much as they might. I think CM tried to get some guys to hurt me, but, you know. So it was a little easier, I think, back then than it would be now. And I'll be honest with you, probably anybody who can do that today is gone after their freshman or sophomore year. They're gone, you know. So you say about the record being asking, you know, it's probably why it has lasted that long.
A new episode of the Talking Tigers podcast is released every Monday. Wherever you listen to podcasts, like and subscribe to the Talking Tigers podcast, only from the Auburn Sports Network.
Hey, this is Kevin Tutto, owner of Baumhauer's Victory Grill in Auburn. It's basketball season, and we've got you covered with 77 TVs to watch all of your favorite games. Come in and enjoy ice-cold beer and your favorite wings with our happy hour specials from 11 to 6 daily Sunday through Friday. Want to have a watch party to cheer on your Auburn Tigers? Call in and reserve a spot on our new patio for your group party. And the NCAA tournament is right around the corner. We are your official March Madness headquarters with all games televised. Baumhauer's Victory Grill in Auburn. War Eagle.
We're back in the Auburn Sports Network studios. It's the Conecuh Sausage Halftime Report. A total of 19 turnovers in the first half, 6 ties, 8 lead changes. Auburn only led for a minute, Tennessee for 17 minutes and change. Volunteers have the lead at the half, 44-40. Let's take a look around Auburn Athletics now. This check around Auburn is brought to you by Auburn Bank, champions of you. Auburn softball has added a game tomorrow night against Georgia State. That'll be a 6 o'clock start at Jane B. Moore Field. That precedes the weekend where Mickey Dean and company will play six more games Friday to Sunday against USC Upstate, Northwestern, and North Texas, all part of the Jane B. Moore Memorial. Tomorrow, Tiger Talk comes your way. That's tomorrow night on the network. 6 Central, we're live at Baumhauer's Victory Grill. You'll hear from Bruce Pearl and others to get you ready for the weekend in Auburn Athletics. Women's basketball is in action tomorrow night at home against Mississippi State. It's a 7 o'clock start at Neville Arena. It's the final home game of the regular season for Coach Jay's club, and bubble implications for sure in that matchup. Just an absolutely incredibly important game for women's basketball at 7. If you're in the Auburn area within an hour or two from Auburn, come over, get your tickets, and watch this final home game of the regular season and support the Tigers. And then baseball, Friday opens its regular season against UConn. Game scheduled for 6 Central. Saturday's game and Sunday's game both start at 1 o'clock Central time. That's a look around Auburn Athletics. Men's basketball trails Tennessee by 4 at the break up in Knoxville. 44-40, your score. We'll take a look at the numbers from the first 20 minutes when the Kaneka Sausage Halftime Report continues in a moment.
Kaneka Sausage is a fan favorite for tailgating, always great on the grill, and it's the official sausage dog and hot dog of the Auburn Tigers. Kaneka Sausage is made from the finest cuts of pork, their patented blend of seasonings, and smoked over a pure hickory fire for that true southern flavor. Be sure to visit the Kaneka Gift Shop in Evergreen, Alabama, right off I-65 at exit 96. Enjoy a crowd-pleasing Kaneka sausage dog while watching the Tigers and make Kaneka part of your game day. Kaneka sausage since 1947, a real winner.
By now, your daily routine is probably a little too routine. Don't you want to change? Don't you want to start playing by your own rules and escape the routine so your fantasy becomes reality? Where every night is an adventure, where new flavors are ready to be tasted, where it feels like you're a winner. Take a chance. Reward yourself. Make your routine anything but routine. Escape every day at Wind Creek Casino and WindCreekCasino.com.
When the game goes into overtime, but the game goes into overtime, the choice to enjoy is easy. Bud Light, easy to drink, easy to enjoy. Order Bud Light online today. Enjoy responsibly. Anheuser-Busch Bud Light Beer, St. Louis, Missouri.
Damaging an underground utility can cause a lot more problems than you think by causing a potentially avoidable.
Made one apiece in the first half for the Tigers, so 5 of 12 from there. Tennessee 4 of 8. Tennessee plus 5 at the free throw line. They were 14 of 15. Auburn 9 of 10 in the first half. Slight edge on the glass for the Volunteers, 18 rebounds to 15 for Auburn. Offensive rebounds 5 to 4 for Tennessee. Second chance points, though, 4-2 in favor of Auburn, so they kind of neutralized Tennessee's offensive rebounding. They did not neutralize the points off turnovers, though. Auburn gave it away 10 times. That's about their season average. Tennessee gave it away 9 times. Volunteers converted better, though. They made 11 points out of Auburn's turnovers. Tigers with just 5 points. Turnovers, Tigers with just 5 points off of those Volunteer TOs. Individual numbers. Tennessee led by Dalton Kanek, as you might expect. He had 12 points on 3 of 5 shooting. He was 2 of 2 from distance and 4 of 4 at the free throw line. Jonas Adu also in double figures with 10 points. He took more shots than any other Tennessee player. He was 4 of 7 from the floor. Adu also the team's leading rebounder with 4. For Auburn, 9 for Denver Jones, 2 of 3 shooting, 1 of 2 from distance, 4 of 4 at the free throw line. 7 points apiece for Chad Baker-Mazzara and Janai Broome. Broome also led everybody with 5 boards in the first half. Janai also had 2 assists. Auburn with 9 assists on their 13 made field goals. Finishing out the scoring for the Tigers, half a dozen points for KD Johnson on 2 of 4 from the floor, and then 5 points for Jalen Williams in his return. 8 minutes on the floor for Jalen in the first half. He was 2 of 3 shooting, made 1 of his 2 three-point tries, also had an assist in the first half. So 5 for Jalen, 4 points for Chaney Johnson on 2 of 4 shooting. Chaney with 3 big rebounds as well in 12 minutes. And then to round out the scoring, 2 points for Aiden Holloway. He was 1 for 2, a nice driving layup for Aiden. He also had 2 assists in the first half. Foul trouble, Dalton Kanek and Vescovi. Vescovi was held scoreless, by the way. Nice job defensively by the Tigers. He did have three rebounds, only took one shot, but only played 10 minutes. He had two fouls in the first half of play. Auburn foul trouble. Aiden Holloway has two. Dylan Cardwell has two. So both teams have two players with two fouls. Zakai Ziegler, Auburn did a good job defensively on him, and this is something to watch in the second half. He was one of five from the floor. He had five assists, but he also had four turnovers. So the Tigers did a good job defensively against Ziegler in the first half. It all adds up, all of that, to a really tight game. It's going to be an entertaining second half. You're going to want to stick around.
You've been listening to the Koneka Sausage Halftime Show. Make Koneka Sausage part of your game day. Still family owned and made in Evergreen, Alabama since 1947. The second half is 2 minutes away. This is the Auburn Sports Network.
Seasons Federal Credit Union is offering a 7-month CD at an annual percentage yield of 5.64% and a 13-month CD at an annual percentage yield of 5.38%. Four Seasons Federal Credit Union is the financial institution for you. This promotion is for new deposits only with a $2,500 minimum. Membership eligibility required. Accounts are federally insured by the National Credit Union Administration. Contact us, Tracy. Contact us for more details.
At Jewelry by Design, we design and hand make officially licensed Auburn University jewelry. We are fully stocked with them. Come by Jewelry by Design and see all of our fabulous designs. And just for looking, receive a free $60 Auburn charm. Just say,
Auburn, Opelika, and East Alabama, a steadfast partner to our customers, meeting financial needs at just the right times. How do we know our community so well? Because we've grown up together. Auburn Bank, champions of you. Member FDIC, online at auburnbank.com.
Welcome back to Food City Center, Thompson Bowling Arena in Knoxville. Auburn trails number four Tennessee at the half, 44-40. Along with Randall Dickey, I'm Andy Burcham, Brad Law in our Auburn Sports Network studios, Quinn Brekeen at the controls in Phoenix, Skyview. All right, second half, Auburn down four. What does Auburn need to do, Randall?
I think three things. I think we need to eliminate the silly turnovers. We're going to make some mistakes, but we gave the Volunteers way too many easy opportunities on points off turnovers was a little bit too much. So I think we eliminate our unforced turnovers, try to get a good shot every time down the floor, maybe go inside a little bit more, and understand what time, score, and momentum is going down the stretch. We had the lead with a minute 37 to go, 1-point lead. All of a sudden, we're going to halftime down four. We need to understand that with the possession of the basketball, know what the time, what the score is, and who has the momentum.
Auburn will have the ball to open the second half of play. Aiden Holloway, Denver Jones, Chad Baker Mazzara, Chaney Johnson, and Janai Broom, the Auburn five. Ziegler, Vescovy, James, Connect, and Adu for Tennessee. Leading scorer for Auburn, Denver Jones with 9. Leading scorer for Tennessee, Dalton Connect with 12. Jonas Adu had 10.
I think you got to watch the Volunteers on two things. I think Connect's going to try to get more shots up, and I think Vescovy is going to try to get involved offensively as well.
Vescovy did not score in the first half. Auburn will have it to open the second half of play. Down four, Auburn ball. Inbound in the backcourt for Holloway. We're underway, Tigers, to the basket to our left in this second half of play. Holloway bounce pass, Broom. For Chaney Johnson, left wing for Holloway. Low post, Janai, triple teamed. Throws it to the baseline and out of bounds. Dag, done it. Janai was triple teamed. He was trying to get the ball to Denver Jones. Auburn said that Janai's hand was held as he tried to pass that ball, but to no avail.
It's been an emphasis on Tennessee's defense all night. When the ball goes to touches Janai's hands, he has a lot of traffic around him.
Tennessee by four with the ball. Ziegler, a three ball off the right side, good. He ended the first half with a three. He opens the second half with a three. And the Vols lead by 7, their largest lead of the game. Left wing, Chaney Johnson. Low post, Chad Baker Mazzara. Head fake, shoots it, miss it. Rebound tapped, and it comes to Connect.
Chad Baker's just having a hard time getting the ball and going to basket tonight.
Connect to the hole. It's knocked out of his hand. And a foul called on Chad Baker Mazzara. Second foul on Chad, and it puts Connect at the free throw line. Tennessee by seven, and Connect at the line for two. They're 14 of 15 from the line tonight.
Another thing we've got to do is get back a little bit quicker. They're getting the ball down and getting the ball close to the basket way too fast on transition offense.
Free throw is good for Connect. He can take it to the lead to nine. Free throw's good. They press Auburn to Broome. Now to Holloway up the floor. Across midcourt. Aiden gets a little room against Ziegler. Now to the top four, Chad Baker Mazzara. Ball deflected, left side is Steele. Vescovy fouled by Jones.
That's one thing that Tennessee has, active hands. They've always got a hand in the passing lane, and if you're a little bit lazy on your pass and not crisp with it, Tennessee will knock it down and go the other way.
Well, turnovers are just killing Auburn in this second half. That's the 12th of the night for Auburn, their second of the second half. Tennessee with an opportunity to take the lead into double figures right here.
Just a little bit nonchalant with our passes, not nearly crisp enough.
Ziegler across midcourt. Out at the top, right wing for Connect. To the corner, James penetrates. Ball knocked out of his hand. A steal for Auburn and a foul on Holloway. That's the third foul on Aiden. He went for a steal.
He sure did.
Did come up with the ball and undercut the Tennessee player. Golly. Right now, nothing going Auburn's way.
Yeah, we're going to have to dig ourselves out just a little bit here before it gets away from us right here. Establish ourselves, kind of get back in rhythm.
49 to 40 balls with the ball, 18-40 in the second. Connect the inbound to Adu, knocked out of bounds by Broome. Glad he was a call for a foul. Donaldson in for Auburn, replacing Holloway, who just picked up his third foul.
Every catch is tough on both ends. Both teams are playing really aggressive and playing up in the passing lanes and putting a lot of pressure on the basketball. It's making it tough to make it an easy pass, that's for sure.
Inbound in the backcourt for Ziegler. To the right wing, Vescovy. Top of the circle for Adu. Couple dribbles, hands to Connect there. Down the lane, Connect to the hole. Missed it short, rebound, Broome, and Auburn was out of bounds. And Tigers are looking for a break here in the second half.
They just keep playing just like we are. We had that, the effort was there. We just unfortunately were standing on a line when the ball caromed off the rim.
And we make the officials talking. Are they going to give Tennessee a full 30-second shot clock here? Tennessee, the officials explained it to the Tennessee bench.
Reviewing the shot clock to make sure it was reset or not reset appropriately.
We appreciate Tennessee supplying a ref mic tonight.
That is nice. We at least get to know kind of what's going on there.
Both teams to their benches with 18:25 to go in the second half of play. Tennessee on top of Auburn 49-40. It was a quick review.
Confirmed, the ball hit rim, reset of the shot clock.
All right, so the shot clock stays at 20. 18:25 in the second half, Tennessee 49, Auburn 40. Tennessee has outscored Auburn 5-0 to start the second half. Tennessee out of bounds, baseline left. James will trigger. In the corner, Adu. Low post, Connect. Turnaround jumper blocked and rebounded by Chaney Johnson. On the break for the Tigers. Chaney Eurostep drives to the hole and he is hammered. Chaney will go to the line for two. The foul will go against James or Jonas Adu, his second.
Chaney Johnson showed a little bit further advanced in his game that time, going coast to coast on that.
They isolated him at the Tennessee end, and he made the balls pay.
He sure did. They were going to get connect the ball. He was matched up on connect there. But deflect it, go get it, and take it to the basket.
Free throw falls for Cheney.
And draw the foul. Let's get two right here and kind of start clawing our way back in.
49-41 balls, 18-15 in the second. Second free throw by Cheney, missed it. Rebound to connect for the balls. Tigers trail by eight, 18-08 in the second half. Ziegler working on Denver Jones at the top, penetrates. Drives, reverse layup, he missed it. Rebound Cheney Johnson. Outlet to Trey Donaldson. Down eight, Auburn basketball. Under 18 minutes in the second half. Low post, Broom. Janai, near a double team. Underneath, Johnson up for the shot. Ball knocked out of his hand and out of bounds. And they're going to give the ball to Tennessee.
Well, I wondered why Janai did not shoot that ball.
Agreed.
He had a good post position, and he's so unselfish, though.
He did get doubled, and Vescovi called for a foul coming up to try and get the entry pass against Denver Jones. And that's the third foul on Santiago Vescovi. He almost lowered the shoulder on Denver to accept the pass.
Well, he certainly initiated the contact.
Yeah, he did. He will come out. And Jordan Ganey is in at that two. Down eight, Auburn ball, out of bounds, baseline left.
This is where we like it, baseline
Cheney,
out of bounds.
Inbound in the corner, Chad Baker-Mazar. Low post, Cheney against Josiah Jorah James. Left wing for Donaldson. Puts it on the floor on the left wing. Backs it up with a left-hand dribble, eight to shoot. Donaldson, a screen from Broom. Drives, top of the circle, down the lane. Donaldson from 15 missed it. Rebound, Broom back up. Got it as the shot clock went off.
Great offensive rebound. Being sometimes you got to be lucky to be in the right place at the right time.
It trims the lead to six. 17-20 in the second half. 49-43 balls. Tennessee basketball. Top of the circle. Connect on the right wing. Long three connect. No. Rebound Denver Jones for Auburn. Up the middle of the floor. Left wing, Chad Baker-Mazara. Goes baseline against Connect. Down the lane. Off the right side, Jones. Denver to the right wing for CBM. Low post, Broom. Janai with the left hand puts it home.
Beautiful jump hook by Broom. Did a great job. The Tigers moved the ball from one side of the floor to the other. Got Broom on the post up.
Ziegler drives, hangs, missed it. Rebound tapped up by Adu. Got it again and put it in. 51-45 Tennessee, 16-34 to go in the second half. Auburn basketball, Broom. At the perimeter, Chad Baker-Mazara. Kicks it out to the top for Cheney Johnson, left wing Donaldson. Low post, Broom, spins on Adu. Hang, shoots, scores, and a foul!
Very good. Tigers are going down to the well, going down to Janai Broom and getting some production, and has a chance for a three-point play.
And the third foul on Jonas Adu. 16-22 to go in the second half. He can cut the lead to three. Can Janai Broom.
Tigers have done a good job clawing out from behind, working their way back into this game.
13 points for Janai Broom. He has six rebounds as well. He's at the line for the and one for the Tigers. Free throw. Missed it. Rebound tapped. It's run down in the corner. Chad Baker-Mazara. And he throws it off the Tennessee player out of bounds. He threw it off the shoulder. Off the shoulder of Josiah Jordan James, and Auburn keeps the ball.
Really good hustle by Bizarro right there to retrieve that ball before it going out of bounds.
Jalen Williams in, Cheney Johnson out. Tigers down four with the ball. 16-18 in the second half. Out of bounds on the right side, or down the right baseline. 18 to shoot for the Tigers. Jalen will trigger. Lobs it inbound for Chad Baker-Mazar to the top for Donaldson. At the point, it's Broom. Off the right side, Donaldson. 10 to shoot for Auburn. Chad Baker-Mazar, a three ball. Missed it. Rebound to the floor. Here's Tennessee the other way. Connect on the break. Auburn gets back. Connect, the screen. Drives down the lane against Broom, and he missed it. The rebound outlet comes to Jones. Denver the other way for Auburn. Off the right wing, Jalen. Goes baseline. He gets contact, and Jalen puts it in.
And scores. The Tigers are really battling hard. defending physically and being have, and also being offensively productive right now.
That cuts the lead to two, and Ziegler is fouled by Denver Jones at the top. With a timeout on the floor. Auburn making a run here in Knoxville. 15:36 to go in the second. Tennessee 51, Auburn 49. The second half tonight presented by Wind Creek Hotel and Casino. With three Alabama locations in Atmore, Montgomery, and Wetumpka, you can escape every day at Wind Creek Hotel and Casino and online at windcreek.com. Auburn basketball continues in a moment.
The Whataburger Jalapeno Cheddar Biscuit is back, but some folks have yet to try it. So let's not do the thing where we're like, you've never had a jalapeno cheddar biscuit before? You know what? It's okay. Let's just invite them to try this flaky, cheesy, and slightly spicy goodness for themselves. The Jalapeno Cheddar Biscuit, available as a sandwich or on its own from 11 p.m. to 11 a.m. for a limited time at participating locations. Whataburger, just like you like it.
Let's face it, nothing makes you look older than you really are than thinning hair. But what if you could not only increase your hair count, but promote new hair growth without surgery, without drugs with potential side effects, and without a prescription from your doctor? Well, now you can, thanks to a breakthrough new supplement called Hair Grow, provided by New Nordic, the number one supplier of dietary supplements in Europe. Hair Grow is now available in the U.S. Only Hair Grow contains Tokogaya, a powerful antioxidant that has received a U.S. patent. Multiple clinical studies show hair growth is safe and effective in promoting new hair growth. In one study, 95% of the patients using hair growth saw increased hair count. Don't lose more time and more hair. Try hair growth today to feel and look your best. Just go to newnordicusa.com or visit Walgreens or Amazon to purchase. Look younger and feel more confident with Hair Grow by New Nordic at newnordicusa.com.
Alabama Power is proud to present this broadcast of Auburn basketball. Alabama Power, power for a better Alabama.
Welcome back to Knoxville. Tennessee 51, Auburn 49. Auburn has hit four of its last five field goals. The Vols just one of their last eight. Tennessee led by as much as nine. And Auburn has the lead down to two at the 15:36 mark of the second half of play.
Well, I think the biggest adjustment is defensively. We came out in that first segment really physical. Tennessee shooting 22% in the second half. So the physicality has really affected Tennessee's offense. We just need to continue to convert on the other end and keep getting Janai Broome the basketball, Jalen Williams on an angle on one block, Janai on the other. That's a double whammy right there.
19th straight game for Janai Broome in double figures. He has an opportunity for his 57th, make that 58th career double-double here tonight. He leads Auburn with 13 points. He has six rebounds.
You know, the Tigers have got 14 turnovers compared to the Vols 10. The biggest difference in that stat is a little bit high for Auburn in turning that ball over. Most of them have been really unforced. They've been in a transition situation that thinking a player was going to outrun the other player and end up tossing the ball out of bounds. But the Vols have made us pay. They've got to correct that a little bit.
It's one of the big differences in this game. There aren't many, but that's one of them. 15:36 in the second. Tennessee 51, Auburn 49. Donaldson Berman, Jalen Williams, Katie Johnson, Janai Broome, the Auburn five. Connect, James, Awaka, Ziegler, and Gainey for Tennessee. Ball's ball. Connect will trigger with Lior Berman face guarding on the sideline down the right side. Still looking. Throws it inbound. Ziegler down the right side of the lane. Brings it out to the wing. Loops out to the top with 18. Off the left wing, Gainey. Around the perimeter. James against KD, who knocked it away. KD behind the back dribble. Leaves for Donaldson to KD. And Auburn will work on the offense with a chance to tie it or take the lead. KD goes baseline, gets bunked by Ziegler. Out to the top, Broome. Donaldson head fake at a long three with 15 to shoot. He backs up. Chance to tie it right here for Auburn. Donaldson gets a screen from Broome. Drives. Picks it up. Gets the ball to Jalen. Three ball on the right wing for the lead. In and out. Rebound. Here's Ganey the other way for Tennessee. Ganey bumped by Donaldson at the free throw line. First foul on Trey. It is the fifth foul against Auburn in the second half.
I thought the ball at Jalen's shot was going to go down. It kind of went halfway down and then spit it right back out.
Meshack into the lineup for Tennessee. As Connect will trigger at the right sideline. For Ziegler at the top. Down two, Auburn on defense. 14:48 in the second half on a counting clock. Ziegler at the top. Picked up on a switch by Donaldson. Now Broome. They've got a Waka underneath as Broome goes underneath. Ziegler to the hole, hangs, puts it up, draws the foul on Donaldson. He's a good actor. He's a really good actor. Trey, and they're going to call that all night long, at least at that end of the floor.
Trey did a good job defensively. Had his hands up, put his body square on him. And
Bruce Pearl right now telling the officials, listen, you call it there on that end, you better do the same thing at ours. Ziegler, 71%, gets a couple here. And the first is good. Tennessee now 17 of 18 from the line tonight. Gives Tennessee a three-point lead. 14:35 to go in the second half. Ziegler's second free throw in and out. Rebound comes to Jalen Williams. Down three, Auburn ball. 14 and a half minutes to go in the second half in Knoxville. Donaldson left wing, KD. At the top, it's Jalen. Back to the wing, KD. Whistle foul. It's going to go against Awaka as he was playing defense against Jani Broome. First foul on Tobe Awaka.
Well, the first segment, it was kind of a wrestling match. This segment here is a little bit, they're blowing the whistle a little bit more.
Inbound in the corner for Berman. Spins. Whistle. Foul. Foul's going to go against Ganey. 5th foul against Tennessee. 2nd foul on Jordan Ganey. Well, now they are calling it at Auburn's end of the floor.
I think that, I'm kind of speechless on that.
Inbound Broome mid lane. Double teamed up with a left hand. It's good.
Beautifully done. Great baseline out of bounds by the Tigers. Got it to Broome and nice lay in.
15 for Jani. Connect left wing three. Didn't get it. Broome gets the rebound. Auburn down one. Lob ahead. Williams. Berman to the hole. He got it. Auburn takes the lead.
I don't think the ball hit the floor but once on that off for a defensive rebound and advanced it up the floor.
53-52 Auburn, Awaka low post, he scores over Broome. Boy, Tennessee did a good job getting that ball up the floor in a hurry.
They do.
Low post, Broome, outside the lane against Awaka, throws it. Berman, corner, three. The Bermanator for three!
Back-to-back scores for Leor.
And Auburn goes up two.
Outstanding finish on the transition offense and then a great three right there.
And KD called for a foul at the top on Zakai Ziegler. And that is KD's second foul. And Auburn seventh. They're shooting free throws the rest of the night. 13:32 to go in the second half. Auburn by two, 56-54. Leor Berman, 5 straight points for Auburn.
What a beautiful three-point shot.
Wasn't it though? Ziegler, the free throw. He didn't get it. Leor gets the rebound. Mike Tennessee thought it was a two-shot foul the way they broke for that rebound. Or didn't. Donaldson across midcourt for the Tigers. Lobs to Berman, left wing. Leor, low post, Jalen Williams. Spins with the left hand, baked it in, and got fouled in a play.
The Tigers are going to work offensively, executing to superbly run that play for the cross screen by Broome. Got Williams wide open and a great delivery pass by Leor Berman.
Auburn by four at the 13:16 mark of the second half. Meshack picked up his second foul. Jalen at the line for the and one. Meshack comes out for the balls. And Adu back in.
It just seems like he's such a presence for their team. They weren't the same when Adu went out.
Williams free throw. Good.
Nicely done by Jalen. Good finish.
10 points for Jalen tonight. Auburn by 5, 59-54. 13-11 in the second half. Inside the arc, Ziegler. Whistle foul away from the ball. Auburn wanted a 3-second violation. Instead, they called a foul against Dylan Cardwell. Eighth foul against Auburn. And Awaka at the line, a one and bonus for the Vols. Big physical sophomore out of Hyde Park, New York, went to Cardinal Hayes High School, played for the U.S. Under-19 World Cup team, the Gatorade Player of the Year in the second half. Ziegler, free throw line, goes down. Golly, come on. If he falls down, you don't have to call the shot, the foul.
Especially when you're trying to avoid to touch him.
They call the second foul on Jalen Williams. They're calling everything now.
Every possession.
Yep, every possession. There's a foul at that end of the floor, and Ziegler's at the line for a one in bonus. Auburn, they'll be in the double bonus as the free throw is up, and he missed it. Rebound out of bounds. Foul on the play. Foul on Awaka, his second.
So far, so good, and they've been a little consistent. That was.
And that foul will put Jalen Williams at the line for a one in bonus.
You hardly ever see a foul called on a free throw.
Rebound. Right.
They usually let you just do what you need to do.
Jalen Williams gets a couple towels to wipe off the perspiration on his hands. He goes to the line for a one and one. That was the seventh foul on Tennessee.
Well, both of these teams are really important. Yeah. You know, we're 59, 55. Make these two. Keep making Tennessee feel the pressure right here.
Free throw by Jalen. Good.
Because you got about 40 seconds here. You're going to have a chance to. You got a media timeout at the 12-minute mark. Probably got two possessions left. Try to at least win one of those after making this free throw.
Second free throw for Jalen. Good.
Beautifully done. Really has been a spark off the bench tonight for the Tigers.
6-point lead for Auburn. 61-55, 12:35 to go, second half. Gainey off the right wing, picked up by KD. Down the lane, lobs it up there. He didn't get it. Rebound, though, Awaka for Tennessee. That's just a good rebound. Tennessee in the corner. Double team. In some trouble. Vescovi throws it away. Here's KD the other way. KD drives and he got fouled. Vescovi got double teamed. He tried to step through it. His pass was intercepted by KD, and I think Vescovi just picked up the foul.
If it would have been anyone else would have lost that ball, KD Johnson was strong with it.
KD back to the line for the second of the N1s. Free throw. Good. Auburn's lead is 8, 63-55, 12-14 in the second half. Auburn goes to his, is Auburn in his zone?
They are. They may go back man after the first pass, though.
Gainey, Ziegler at the top.
They're going to stay in the zone.
To connect. He'll shoot over the three. He got it.
That was deep.
Well, he recognized the zone, didn't he?
That was deep. He just backed up about three steps.
63-58 Auburn, Tiger basketball. Donaldson for KD. Top of the circle, behind the back dribble. 17 to shoot KD. Picks it up, lobs it to Broom. Broom around Adu, to the hole, hammered. And a foul is called against Awaka. That'll be the third on Awaka. And it takes us to a timeout. 11:38 to go in the second. Auburn 63, Tennessee 58. Great things are possible when you have the power, performance, and smart features of a Ford F-150, the official truck of the Auburn Tigers. Greatness starts at your local Ford dealer. Stay tuned. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly.
Here's a clip from a recent Talking Tigers podcast with Andy Burcham.
Mike Lutzenkirchen.
You know, he's one of four kids. He's got two older sisters, a younger sister. And I think our fans typically look at these kids that are so big and think they're adults right away just because of their size. He was a mama's boy. Had a great relationship, unique relationship with each of his sisters. To me, his nickname was Boof. Boof, I don't even quite frankly remember how it all started.
Boof.
You know, I'd show up on sidelines of games here at Auburn. He'd like, the girls be like, so how quick do you think you'll get on the sideline this game without a pass? I said, I don't know, we'll see what can happen. And I'd be on that sideline. He'd come, be coming, run across, doing that one stretch from sideline to sideline. He'd just look at me and goes, of course you made your way. Sideline to sideline. He'd just look at me and goes, of course you made your way down here. And Phil was my best friend.
A new episode of the Talking Tigers podcast is released every Monday. Wherever you listen to podcasts, like and subscribe to the Talking Tigers podcast, only from the Auburn Sports Network.
Hi, my name is Alani.
Second half, there hadn't been a lot of flow in this second half, but that hasn't bothered Auburn.
On his free throw.
15 points and 7 rebounds tonight for Janai. He missed both. Rebound out of bounds off of Chaney Johnson. That's Auburn's first misses from the free throw line. Now Auburn is 6 of 10 in the second half from the free throw line. Tennessee's only 4 of 8. Auburn leads it, 63-58, Tennessee ball.
Tigers going to stay in the zone.
Gainey, Adu, connects to the dunk. Cuts the lead to 3. Time for Auburn to respond.
Yeah, I think the Vols are ready for that.
11-18 in the second half. Berman outside the arc. Underneath Broom. Janai backs his way in. Head fake, spins up, missed it short. Rebound Tennessee. Awaka rebounded. Here comes Connect up the floor. Auburn matches up Donaldson on him. He drives past to Auburn. 15-footer, didn't get it. Rebound, Adu falls down. Gets it back. Low post to Waka. Connect up and a foul.
Had to foul him then. We missed the 50-50 ball. The ball was on the floor. We didn't come up with it. Unfortunate that Connect got it, and we had to foul him at the basket.
Third foul on KD Johnson. And Connect is at the line for 2. KD frustrated as he comes off the floor. Denver Jones and Chad Baker-Mazar about to come in.
Yeah, don't blame him. He was in there scrapping so hard and fighting so hard, and he just wasn't successful at it.
Connect 76% from the line this season. And the free throw is missed. He missed it long. That's his first miss of the night. Tennessee 18 of 24 in the game. 4 of 9 in the second half.
Well, he really, and I don't want to hex us a little bit, but he hadn't been the same since Chaney Johnson blocked his shot.
He gets the second free throw.
But he did make the 3, and he made that free throw right there, but he's a good player.
2-point game. Donaldson up the floor, picked up by Zakai Ziegler as they come to their feet in Knoxville. Donaldson outside the arc, Broom underneath. Chad Baker-Mazar behind the defense, put it in.
Beautiful set play, great pass, and an excellent finish.
Auburn by 4, 65-61, 10.5 minutes to go in the second half. Ziegler as Auburn goes back to a man. Ziegler to the wing for Connect, picked up by Chaney. Puts it on the floor and drives. And he's fouled. It will go against Chaney Johnson. They're shooting 2 the rest of the night. Auburn's 1 foul away from the double bonus as well. And Connect back at the line for 2 more. Leads the SEC in league games at 24.4 points a game. First free throw is good. 21 tonight.
Yeah, he's on pace to get his average.
Yeah.
He's a three-level threat. You really identified that well. He can shoot the 3, he can shoot the mid-range, and he can score at the basket and certainly at the free throw line.
And he knocks on both. The foul, they called it against Gainey, his 3rd. 65-63. Broom from the line tonight is 0 of 4. Knock home this first one, big boy. And he does.
There we go. See that ball go in the basket. It's going to give him a little bit better. He's a little good, little bit stiff after he came off that bench on that time.
Midway mark of the ball game. Second half, Auburn 66, Tennessee 63.
Tiger
Ziegler,
zone.
Connect and a long 3 good. He's tied the ball game.
That's deep. That's deep there.
Yeah. Auburn, Tennessee tied at 66. Donaldson at the top against Ziegler. Crossover with the screen. Free throw line to Broom. Had the 3. Takes the 3. Makes the 3!
That was outstanding. What a shot. I think the Tigers are going to go back man. They've got they've gotten burned the last couple of possessions going in the zone. And
Chad Baker-Mazar now on Connect, who has it at the right wing. Tigers by 3. Tennessee ball. Connect on the wing. Picked up by Chaney in a switch. Picks it up. Right back to Ziegler. 9 to shoot. 3 ball to tie it. Good.
Big time plays the last 2 possessions. One by Broom, one by Ziegler right there to tie it up.
Tied at 69, Auburn ball. Broom out at the top. Right wing, Chad Baker-Mazzara. Chaney Johnson straight away, and a turnover. Threw it out of the glove or out of the hands of Donaldson.
Yep.
Holloway is in, so is Jalen Williams. Donaldson and Chaney sit down. We're tied at 69, 8:51 in the second half, and a timeout called by Auburn. Auburn basketball brought to you by East Alabama Health. With more than 80 physicians added in the past 5 years, they're growing their healthcare team to meet the growing needs of Auburn, Opelika, and the surrounding area. We're tied at 69, Tennessee ball with 8:51 when we come back. Auburn basketball continues in a moment.
This is the moment you've been waiting for.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our home.
When you step onto the court and into the spotlight, the moment to show that hard work and long days pay off. Because when that final shot leaves your hands and we leave our seats, that powerful moment connects us all.
Alabama Power is a proud supporter of the Auburn Tigers.
Power for a better Alabama.
With Vizzy's vibrant dual flavors, the vibe is yours to decide.
I'm thinking Vizzy Refreshingly Berry. A round of blackberry lemon at the bar?
Could be good. Maybe Vizzy Vibrantly Tropical.
You always say vibrantly tropical.
Come on, a cooler full of papaya passion fruit on the beach?
Oh yeah, that's a vibe. I'm down.
Vizzy Hard Seltzer. Flavor for every vibe. Naturally flavored with other natural flavors. Celebrate responsibly. 2023 Molson Coors Beverage Company. Milwaukee, Wisconsin flavored beer.
Hey, this is Kevin Tutto, owner of Baumhauer's Victory Grill in Auburn. It's basketball season, and we've got you covered with 77 TVs to watch all of your favorite games. Come in and enjoy ice-cold beer and your favorite wings with our happy hour specials from 11 to 6 daily, Sunday through Friday. Want to have a watch party to cheer on your Auburn Tigers? Call in and reserve a spot on our new patio for your group party. And the NCAA tournament is right around the corner. We are your official March Madness headquarters with all games televised. Baumhauer's Victory Grill in Auburn. War Eagle.
A look at the defensive statistics is brought to you by Cook's Pest Control and Centricon. You don't have to live with termites.
Can't talk about this game without talking about turnovers. 15 for Auburn, 12 for Tennessee. The big difference, though, is what Tennessee has done with those turnovers. They've outscored Auburn 14-9 off turnovers tonight. Auburn and Tennessee tied at 69 with 8:51 to go in the second half of play. Both teams in the double bonus for the rest of this one. Auburn is led by as many as 8, Tennessee by 9, we're tied. We have had 11 lead changes. The game has been tied 8 times. Auburn with 17 assists, Tennessee with 11. Bench points, Auburn 25, Tennessee 18. Points in the paint, Auburn 26, Tennessee 18. Dalton Connect with 25 on the night. 4 of 6 from 3, 9 of 10 from the free throw line. Auburn's leading scorer, Jani Broom, 8 of 12 from the field, 2 of 4 from 3, with 7 rebounds on the night. Final 8:51 to go in Knoxville. Number 11 Auburn, number 4 Tennessee, deadlocked at 69.
The Tigers are still scoring it pretty good at a high rate in the second half. The Volunteers, the last two possessions, with Ziegler's 3, Connect's 3, and then his free throw really has given them a shot in the arm momentum-wise. But what a game. I think that you'll see the Tigers continue to try to go down deep to the block, to Broom. We got to get one other guy to show back up, whether it's Jalen Williams or whether it's a timely shot by Mazzara or even Holloway. But we've got to do a really good job. We've got to do a better job on the two guards. We got to come up with a 50-50 ball this last 8 minutes.
Last two threes by Dalton Connect are beyond NBA three-point range.
Yeah, that was a...
Auburn's going to have to extend his defense a little bit, I think.
I think so. I think he did that against the zone. I think the Tigers will go back man-to-man and kind of stick to him a little closer.
Tied at 69. Tennessee basketball. 8:50 or 8:43 on a counting clock. Connect left wing, picked up by Jalen. Head fake and a long three, puts it on the floor. 18-footer Connect, good. He may try to win this game by himself.
Well, he's feeling it right now, and that was a really, it was good defense by Jalen. He had a shot it right over the top of him.
Tennessee by two, Auburn ball, Jalen Williams. Low post shot is up and a foul. Chad Bacon Mazzara knocked down by Connect. And that is the third foul on Dalton Connect. And Chad Bacon Mazzara goes to the free throw line for Auburn.
I think you see the Tigers continue to exploit that. If they can get one more on him, get four, the Volunteers will be forced to take him out.
Tennessee wanted a walk on the play. Instead, they got a foul on their best player. Chad Bacon Mazzara at the free throw line for two.
I think if he can see this ball go in right here, he might get on fire a little bit down the stretch.
First one is good. 10 points on the night for Chad Bacon Mazzara. Tries to tie it with his free throw. In and out. Rebound Connect. Picked up by Chad Bacon Mazzara midcourt, hands the ball to Ziegler. Tennessee by one, 8-10 in the second half. Connect, 18-footer. Yep, Auburn can't stop it. Tennessee by three. Connect has 27. Jalen Williams at the right wing. At the top, Broom around the perimeter, Holloway. Right wing, Chad Bacon Mazzara. Outside the arc, 13 to shoot. Picks up the dribble. Bounce pass, Broom. Drives into the lane. Jani to the hole, no. Rebound, Tennessee. Tennessee by three. And a foul by Jalen at the half court line. Puts Tennessee at the line for two and takes us to a timeout. 7:33 in the second. Tennessee 73. Auburn 70. Find your piece of paradise on the Alabama Gulf Coast with Mindy Jones of RE/MAX Paradise. Visit Mindy at paradise.com. This is the Auburn Sports Network from PlayFly.
Get ready to say War Eagle and sing Take Me Out to the Ball Game as Auburn baseball tickets are now on sale for the 2024 season. Don't miss any of the 32 exciting home games at Plainsman Park as Butch Thompson and your 15th-ranked Auburn Tigers are set to host Arkansas, Tennessee, Kentucky, Ole Miss, and Alabama this season. Opening day on the Plains is set for Friday, February 16th versus Eastern Kentucky. Tickets start at just $12. You can secure yours today at AUBTIX.com. War Eagle.
How are you the ultimate Auburn fan?
Because I got this air horn installed in my throat.
Pretty sick, right?
Yes.
You look really sick. What doctor would even do this?
Doctor? I did this myself. I mean, I can't swallow whole food, but still.
Wait, what?
Just gotta plow through it. Hey, can I get a couple of soups up here? What about some chamomile tea?
Don't be that guy. Get a fan card. The smart way to be the ultimate Tigers fan. Just go to auburncards.com.
By now, your daily routine is probably a little too routine. Don't you want to change? Don't you want to start playing by your own rules and escape the routine so your fantasy becomes reality? Where every night is an adventure, where new flavors are ready to be tasted, where it feels like you're a winner. Take a chance. Reward yourself. Make your routine anything but routine. Escape every day at Wind Creek Casino and WindCreekCasino.com.
Brad Law in the Auburn Sports Network studios will check the Yellowwood scoreboard. Elsewhere in the SEC, South Carolina, Texas A&M are underway in College Station. They've played 8.5 minutes. Gamecocks over the Aggies 14-12. Still loads of time left there. Final in Gainesville, 24th-ranked Florida beats Missouri.
16 on the overall for the field, but he is 4 for 6 from the 3, 9 for 10 from the line. He's having himself a night, and he is not shooting the ball open. We've got Tigers hanging all over on both arms.
He averages 24 points a ball game in SEC play. He leads the league in that statistic. It will go up after tonight's game. He has 29, and he's getting the ball every time Tennessee comes down the floor right now.
Well, there's a lot of players that's played in the SEC over the course of its history that's made an impact their first year, but he certainly carved his way into the annals as far as that's concerned. But it's imperative that the Tigers, we've got to somehow respond somehow we've got to try to get him off kilter, try to make him shoot the ball when he's not in rhythm, to try to create a just where he'll miss just ever just enough for us to get ahead and pull out.
Zakai Ziegler at the line for two. Both teams are shooting two the rest of the night. The first free throw is missed.
And that's been a little bit of the a chink in their armor in the second half.
They're 7 of 14 from the line in the second half.
They hadn't shot the ball from the free throw line very well.
He makes the second. Tennessee by four. 7:33 to go. Holloway against Ziegler. Freshman against senior. Freshman against junior.
Yeah, two outstanding players going head up.
Holloway, left-handed pass, left wing Jones. Low post Broom. Double team to the top. Holloway, right side, Chad Baker-Mazzara, 10 to shoot. Holloway at the top, shot clock down to 7. Right wing, Chad Baker, 5. Chad Baker penetrates down the lane, off the glass, no. Tap up and in by Broom.
Big offensive rebound, stick back by Broom. Somehow, some way, he's on a light connect. When the ball touches Broom's hand, good things happen.
Janai with 19 points on the night. Down 2, Auburn on defense. Ziegler on the wing, connect against Broom. 16 to shoot. Connect for 3. Yes.
That's over a guy 6'10" at about 27 feet.
Tennessee by 5, 77-72. Denver Jones right wing, top of the circle for Jalen. Left wing Jones, low post Broom. Double team, Janai. Baker at the top, Holloway penetrates to the hole, gets hammered, no foul, rebound James in the corner, CBM, good!
Big three.
Back by 2, 77-75, 6:05 in the second half. Tennessee basketball.
That was a great effort by Jalen Williams on retrieving that ball off the offensive glass.
Gainey, right side connect against Broom, penetrates against Janai and jams it. Hangs on the rim, screams at Broom.
I'm kind of for Janai at that time. I think he should have had a little bit of help there.
Tennessee by 4, 79-75. 5:33 in the second. Chad Baker left wing. Inside the arc, Jalen. Broom left wing 3, no. Long rebound Tennessee. Ziegler up the floor. To connect on the right wing. He has made his last 6, including 3 threes. He's double teamed. Low post to Waka, lost it. Here's Auburn the other way. Chad Baker-Mazzara, bounce pass. Jones put it in.
Beautifully done. Nice transition basket for the Tigers.
Cuts the lead to 2.
We finally made connect pass it, and they weren't successful on that offensive possession.
So under 5 minutes to go. Tennessee 79, Auburn 77. Ziegler to the left wing, connect. Way outside the arc, left wing. Nearly double teamed. Awaka to Ziegler. Right wing 3, gaining. No. Rebound Broom. Auburn ball down 2. 4:51. Jalen behind the defense. Put it up. No foul. Of course, no foul. Here's Tennessee the other way. And Auburn's been called for a technical. And Bruce Pearl is all over Byron Jarrett.
I think he felt like that Jalen got fouled on that.
Tennessee with the ball, they'll get 2 free throws in the basketball. We get another look at it. He got hit on the arm going up, and they didn't call it. And they didn't call it. And now connect at the free throw line for 2 for Tennessee. First is missed.
I think this is going to fire the Tigers up a little bit. He missed that free throw.
Yes, he did. Second free throw for connect, and then Tennessee will have the ball. He got the second.
And he kind of rounded that one in as well. It's a 3-point game.
And Tennessee has it with 4:48 to go in the second.
Plenty of time left.
Hard to blame Bruce Pearl.
Oh, you can't.
Yeah. As that ball was batted, so was Jalen at the basket.
Well,
and now the officials are going to the replay.
Yeah, see if he did. If he hit him in the head.
I don't think he got him in the head, no.
But I think he gained an advantage. I really do.
He got him on the arm going by. There's no question about that. That was a missed call. And then Bruce Pearl was called for the foul. Jalen was fouled on his way up. And Byron Jarrett, who missed the call, then teed up Bruce Pearl.
We can go a step further. He also touched the ball in the glass, too.
Tennessee has it out of bounds off the left sideline, leading Auburn by 3, 80-77. Everything will stay the same. There was no flagrant on Tennessee.
At review, the clock is correct.
Oh, they were looking at the clock.
Yeah.
Okay. 4:48 to go. Tennessee ball leading Auburn by 3, 28 on the shot clock. Vescovy is in, replacing Ganey for Tennessee. This is the starting five for the ball. Ziegler, Vescovy, James, Connect, and Adu. Inbound at midcourt, inside midcourt for Ziegler. Screen from Vescovy. Picked up in a switch by Holloway. Connect back to Ziegler. Free throw line. Lobs it alley-oop. They didn't get it. Rebound Auburn the other way. Down three with the ball. Up the floor, Holloway. Right wing. Now backs it up. 4:36 to go in the second. The clock is stopped. The clock is stopped. Off the right side. Now it's moving again. Chad Baker-Mazar behind the back pass and throws it out of bounds. The clock stopped for about 5 seconds.
It sure did.
Tennessee basketball leading Auburn by 3. 4:32 to go in the second half.
There's a little bit of a silly turnover there. Keep our defense up. And the defense that the Tigers are doing now is anytime Connect gets the ball, they're running another guy at him to make him give it up.
Connect has it. Picked up by Chad Baker-Mazara. Now picked up in a switch. Chad Baker back on him. Connect drives to the hole. He banked it in. Tennessee by 5. 4:05 in the second half. It is the Dalton Connect show right now. At the top, Holloway. Right side of the lane, drives into the baseline. Reverses out to the right wing. Shot clock at 10. Chad Baker-Mazara with 8. Around the screen. Free throw line to Broom. 4-3. Williams penetrates, drives to the hole. He banked it up and he missed it. Tennessee ball. They're up 5 with 3.5 minutes to go.
Yeah, it's time for the Tigers to tighten up, make something good happen.
Ziegler working on Denver Jones. Connect pops out to the top, working on Chad Baker-Mazar. They just cleared out for number 3. Connect picks it up in a double team. Underneath Vescovy to Adu, put it in. Tennessee is his 8 of its last 9, and the Vols lead by 7. 3:04 in the second half. Tigers desperately need a bucket. 84-77 Vols. Off the left side, out of bounds. Out of bounds off of Tennessee. Auburn ball out of bounds in the front of its own bench. And now the officials don't know.
They can't see. Nobody makes
the call. Well, yeah, one does. Yeah. Steven Anderson walks over and says that was off Tennessee. They'll probably look at the review. And we've got a timeout. 2:57 to go. 84-77 Tennessee. Auburn ball, we think, going into the timeout. It is Auburn ball. Stay tuned. Auburn basketball continues in a moment.
Take it from me, basketball season is a grind. That's why it's great to get away and recharge in my Ford F-150 truck. With available Pro Power on board, which lets me use F-150 as a mobile generator, I can enjoy the great outdoors while watching games and highlights on my flat-screen TV. Ah, relaxation. Check out the official truck of the Auburn Tigers at your local Ford dealer and tell them Bruce Pearl sent you. See owner's manual for important operating instructions. Some models, trims, and features may not be available and may be subject to change.
You've created a comfortable home office. Now let Carrier provide the cash bonus. For a limited time, you can claim up to $1,550 in cool cash rebates on a qualified Carrier home comfort system. There's never been a better time to upgrade to year-round premium comfort and energy savings.
Carrier, a proud partner of Auburn Athletics and special needs assistance stations for you. Turn to the experts with Carrier.
Hey, I'm Charles Barkley. Call for a Redmont and water at bars and restaurants throughout the great state of Alabama. Redmont Vodka, available at select ABC stores and package stores. Redmont Vodka is 8 times distilled, gluten-free, and is made from non-GMO corn. Looking to support a local business? Redmont Distilling is Alabama proud.
Tennessee by 7, Auburn basketball, 257. Tennessee by 7, Auburn basketball, 257 to go. Dalton Connect, a career-high 37 points tonight. Excuse me. He is 2 under his career-high. He scored 39 against Florida here last month. He has 37 tonight. My goodness. 11 of 19 from the field, 5 of 7 from 3. Auburn ball coming out of the timeout. Desperately needed a bucket right here.
We need to get a decent shot at the basket, and we have not done that the last 2 possessions. And defensively, the 3 possessions we shut them out. We ran a player, an off player to Connect right when he got the ball, made him give it up, and it worked. But a team like Tennessee made a little bit of an adjustment. He got the ball in a sweet spot, which is in the middle of the floor, and he was able to pick us apart when he got the ball out of the double team then with Adu laying it into the basket. So the Tigers are in striking distance here, but we've got to be productive offensively in the next 2 or 3 possessions.
Auburn 17 to shoot. Auburn will trigger in front of its bench. Chad Baker Mazzara. Auburn down 7. Baker, low post, Broom against Adu. Off the right corner. Holloway, 3. Got it!
There we go. It's a good way to start. Great assist by Janai Broom. And found.
Cuts Aiden the lead Holloway to 4. 2:45 second half timeout. Tennessee. Auburn basketball brought to you by Auburn Opelika Tourism. Start your next visit to the Plains at aotourism.com. This is a 30. They had Connect out of the game.
Yeah, they were.
Mike, they called timeout just to get him back in.
They weren't going to waste a possession without him in the game. So they went ahead and called timeout, get him back in the game. It's going to give the Tigers a chance to regroup. They'll call their defense first and foremost, and then the next offensive play on the transition. But it's, whew.
What a game. Oh, what a game.
It's been outstanding. Yeah. And I'm talking about it's like an NCAA first, second round game.
It is a game that you would expect that may help decide at least a part of the SEC championship this season.
It certainly is a championship level. Ooh, that's for
indeed
sure. And from now on, 2:45 left. Not that they haven't been, Andy, but every possession is valuable.
Ziegler, Vescovy, James, Connect, and Adu. Brown or Broom, Jones, Holloway, Baker, Mazzara, and Williams for Auburn. Tennessee out of bounds in front of its bench down the right sideline. Vescovy will trigger. 4-point lead for the Vols. The inbounds of Kai Ziegler. Picked up by Denver Jones. They're all alone over there on the left side. Now Connect pops out to the wing. Chad Baker, Mazzara, they get it to the left side. Ziegler into the lane, down the right side, through the lane. Off the left side, 8 to shoot. Ziegler drives, top of the circle, 4 to shoot. Ziegler to the hole, missed it. Rebound foul against Auburn. With 1:03 on the shot clock. Foul against Denver Jones is 4th.
That's one of the things we talked about a little bit earlier. You got to understand time. Got to have a little bit of a clock in your head.
Zakai Ziegler at the free throw line and a timeout called by Tennessee, or is it Auburn? Clock stop with 2:21 to go.
Flagrant elbow.
Holy cow. They're going to look at a flagrant elbow on the play. Again, our thanks to Tennessee for providing the ref mic tonight.
Yeah, that's really handy. It's been nice to kind of understand and know what's going on, but I'm really concerned about this play here. Well, I was a little bit shut out because of the double team.
Ziegler driving. No, I don't think there's an elbow. Now there's a foul, and he goes to the line for 2. And man, am I looking through orange and blue glasses? You bet I am. But I don't see an elbow to anywhere to the head, but they continue to review this with the folks in Birmingham. I understand the review. I understand why the review is taking place, but every angle we've seen, there was no elbow to the face or the head of Zakai Ziegler. And the headsets come off, and it is a common foul. The foul against Denver is his fourth. Zakai Ziegler at the line, 4-2. With 2:21 to go in the second half, and Tennessee leading Auburn 84-80.
Well, it's a little easier to look at the replay and see that, but I'm not for sure that Denver was the one that got called for the foul, but I'm not for sure Janai didn't foul him, but I'm not for sure he was going away from the basket when the whistle blew.
Broom to the line for two. It's been a bit of an adventure tonight from the line. Seed by six again, a minute 46 to go. Right wing, low post again, a minute 46 to go. Right wing, low post, Broom spins to the basket, kicks it left side, free ball, no. KD at the top, Aiden, left wing, head fake, free ball, Jalen, didn't get it, rebound. Auburn wanted contact on the shot by Jalen. They're not gonna get it, not from this crew tonight. No, Tennessee ball, a minute 23 to go.
Gotta get stops.
Tennessee by six. Connect at the right wing against Broom, double teamed. Ziegler down the lane to the baseline. James out to the wing for Ziegler, eight to shoot to Connect. Almost at midcourt, working on KD. Connect rises up for three, missed it badly, but Vescovi gets the rebound and put it in. His first basket of the night. Tennessee by eight. 54 seconds to go. Holloway drives to the hole. Haynes goes up. And they're not calling anything at this end of the floor now, friends. Nothing. Out of bounds off Tennessee Auburn ball.
It looked like an awful lot of contact with Aiden going to the basket right there.
Not at this end of the floor. Auburn ball out of bounds, baseline right. 19 to shoot, 49 seconds to go. Tennessee by eight, 90-82. Jalen, the inbound. Broom almost at the free throw line. Backs his way down, bounce pass, KD. Off the glass, nobody's fouled. Stops the clock with 44 seconds to go. The foul's against Adu, and he just fouled out. 14 points and 7 rebounds for Adu tonight.
He is a force around that basket.
KD at the line for two for the Tigers. Tennessee's made four of its last five field goals. They've scored every time down the floor of late.
They sure have. And they've got the 50-50 balls and also offensive rebound. That was a kind of a tough blow to overcome on that offensive rebound by Vescovi in this last possession. But the Tigers, anything can happen right here. Make these two free throws, get into a press, create a steal.
Right.
Before you have to get in, you gotta stop that clock because it's your enemy right now.
First to two by KD is good. KD with 9 points on the night. 7-point game, he can cut the lead to seven. 44 seconds to go in the second half. Knocked him home.
Very good by KD, jumping the press, make it hard for Tennessee to get the ball inbounds, try to get a deflection, a quick steal, and another basket.
Ziegler, the inbound to Vescovi, double teamed. Vescovi dribbled it out of bounds, but it was nice touch last by Auburn.
It's going to be a spot throw in. That means he can't move, so that's going to help us on the press right there.
41.3 seconds to go. 6-point Tennessee lead, 90-84. Full length of the floor to go for the Vols. Ziegler will trigger again. The inbound to Vescovi. Double team, gets it back to Ziegler. Fouled in the backcourt by Holloway. Ziegler goes to the line for two.
Well, it's a gamble you got to take, but it's a big situation. Even though they're shooting two free throws, Let's get lucky, Lenny. Miss two, make it a two-possession game here.
37 seconds to go. Tennessee 90, Auburn 84. Ziegler at the line for two. Fourth foul, by the way, against Holloway. Free throw is good. Awaka in, Ganey comes out for the Vols. Ziegler knocks home both.
Made his last four. Got to go
inbound
quickly.
Inbound Broom almost at midcourt. Taking it across midcourt tonight. Gets the ball to Chad Bacon-Mazar. To Holloway. Auburn down eight with the ball. Holloway at the top. Long three, short. Rebound Tennessee. James got the rebound. James will bring it up the floor for the Vols. Auburn will not foul. Final 16 seconds to go. Tennessee will win it. The two head coaches meet at midcourt with a hug. James shakes hands with Jalen Williams, and the Vols win a hard-fought one tonight. Gotta love the heart of both of these teams. Tennessee 92, Auburn 84.
It was an outstanding game. Unfortunate for the Tigers. We fought really hard. Just two or three turnovers, two or three instances that we didn't make plays that we should have. Gave the Vols a little bit of chance to run out on us, get enough lead to cover the 92 to 84, but boy, what two outstanding teams, two really worthy teams to be tops in the SEC.
Tennessee improves to 12-3 in the SEC. They will be at least in a tie for first in the league after tonight. Auburn falls to 10-5. And next up, Auburn home to face Mississippi State Saturday at 3. Final score tonight, Tennessee 92, Auburn 84. Jani Broom led Auburn with 23 points, and you can score points too with the Chick-fil-A app. Download or open the app to place an order. Earn and redeem points with the Chick-fil-A app. War Eagle and eat more chicken. Stay tuned. The Regions Bank postgame show is next. This is the Auburn Sports Network from Playfly.
AuburnTigers.com is the official website of Auburn Athletics. Read the latest feature stories on your favorite Tiger teams. Get critical game day info, search videos and audio. Find out how to get connected through social and digital media or by joining Tigers Unlimited. Shop the AU Photo Store or just find the next event on the athletic calendar. Plus, all athletic broadcasts are streamed free at AuburnTigers.com/watch. AuburnTigers.com, the official online home of Auburn Athletics.
Kaneka Sausage is a fan favorite for tailgating, always great on the grill, and it's the official sausage dog and hot dog of the Auburn Tigers. Kaneka Sausage is made from the finest cuts of pork, their patented blend of seasonings, and smoked over a pure hickory fire for that true southern flavor. Be sure to visit the Kaneka gift shop in Evergreen, Alabama, right off I-65 at exit 96. Enjoy a crowd-pleasing Kaneka Sausage dog while watching the Tigers and make Kaneka part of your game day. Kaneka Sausage, since 1947, a real winner.
Southern homes are particularly vulnerable to termites. In this climate, you need guaranteed protection. You need Cook's Pest Control and Centricon. Termites attack the Centricon stations, exposing themselves to an agent that eliminates their entire colony. Upgrade from old-fashioned liquid service to the proven protection of Centricon and Cook's Pest Control. Call Cook's today for a free evaluation.
Looky, looky, looky.
With Vizzy's vibrant dual flavors, the vibe is yours to decide.
I'm thinking Vizzy Refreshingly Berry. A round of blackberry lemon at the bar?
Could be good. Maybe Vizzy Vibrantly Tropical.
You always say Vibrantly Tropical.
Come on, a cooler full of papaya passion fruit on the beach?
Oh yeah, that's a vibe. I'm down.
Vizzy Hard Seltzer. Flavor for every vibe. Naturally flavored with other natural flavors. Celebrate responsibly. 2023 Molson Coors Beverage Company. Milwaukee, Wisconsin flavored beer.
Exclusive coverage of Auburn basketball continues now with the Regions Bank postgame show. Coming up, final stats, analysis, and an interview with Coach Pearl. Show your Tiger pride and get a win for your wallet with the Auburn University Regions Visa debit card and the prepaid Regions Now card. Order at regions.com/go Tigers. The Regions Bank postgame show begins now.
War Eagle, welcome back to Thompson Bowling Arena in Knoxville. The Vols beat the Tigers by a score of 84-92 tonight. A career-high tying 39 points for Dalton Knecht. 17 for Zagai Ziegler, who's had, both of those guys had 12 free throw attempts tonight. Jonas Adu with 14 for Tennessee. 23 for Janai Broom, who had 9 rebounds. 13 for Chad Baker-Mazzara. 12 for Jalen Williams off the bench. 11 for Denver Jones tonight, but Tennessee prevails 92-84. Every time the Tigers hit a three-pointer, Berkshire Hathaway Home Services donates $25 to Coach Pearl's Outlive Cancer Initiative, benefiting local cancer patients and treatment centers. 9 threes for the Tigers tonight, so that's $225 for Outlive. Auburn had a brief 8-point lead at 63-55 in the second half. Auburn had its last lead in the game, a 3-point lead with 9:36 to go. Down the stretch, just too much Dalton Knecht for the Vols here tonight. Got to give credit where credit is due, Randall.
There's not any doubt. The Tigers played sensational defense up to that point. He took the game over. He went about 3 to 6 possessions there that he was just every eye in this building was on him. And he was productive from about 4 of those, and 3 of them were threes.
There was one time he made 6 consecutive shots at one of the most pivotal points in this ball game tonight.
And he just, and I think it took a little bit of wind out of the Tiger sails there just for a little bit. We relaxed. They got just enough lead, and then we traded baskets down the stretch, and it wasn't enough. We couldn't make a run back. But I'll tell you, the one thing that I'm really proud of the Tigers about, this is one of the few times we've got 5 guys in double-figure scoring. We're starting to get productivity out of multiple players on the offensive end. We shot a good percentage, 47-48% from the field. We got Jalen Williams back, and he got 12 points.
Played 21 minutes tonight.
I know that we would really have wanted to win this game. It was a big decision-making game to kind of move into the higher spot of the SEC, but right, we are still in the hunt, still got an outstanding team, and still going to go deep in the tournament. And it's a really good test tonight for a tournament play.
Final score tonight, Tennessee 92, Auburn 84. A look around the SEC when we come back with Brad Law. The Regions Bank postgame show continues in a moment.
Hi, my name is Alani. A little thing I like about the spicy deluxe sandwich is that you taste the crunch, you taste the pepper jack cheese melting, and you taste the spicy flavors in the sandwich. I'm telling you, 10 out of 10.
Hi, my name's Enrique. A little thing I love about Chick-fil-A.